Well, I always felt that I might be an artist, but it wasn't a very good thing to suggest to one's parents in Melbourne, Australia, in the late 1940s, early 1950s, that one had a serious interest in art. I never studied art, but I used to save up my pocket money and buy art books. My school in Melbourne, which was run a bit like an English public school, there was also an art class. The art class was run by the athletics coach. He knew nothing at all about art, and I must have been a very irritating and priggish pupil. Our city was visited by Laurence Olivier and his wife Vivian Lee. And that was the Old Vic Theatre Company, and they presented three plays. And my parents had bought tickets for each show. Of course, no one went to the theatre for the play. We went there because that's what you did. It was a social event. I was deeply impressed, and it was the first time I thought, wouldn't it be interesting to be an actor? Kids are natural artists. You see marvelous things painted and drawn or written by children, but very soon this gift dies. I suppose I've tried to maintain this infantile attitude of changing personality. And so I have a repertoire of characters that I deploy in the theatre, and they all represent different aspects of myself and different aspects of the world, and particularly the world that I grew up in, which happens to be a little fragment of civilization at the end of the world. As I become more of an old fogey, as I become more respectable, I still manage to give very deep offense to people. When I'm asked what kind of art I especially like, whether it be painting or music or literature, I rather pretentiously say that I like pre-cataclysmic art. That is to say, the art that is produced before some huge upheaval. So I've always been interested, for example, in the music and painting of Central Europe before the Second World War, between the wars, really. That sort of art has an energy. It anticipates, like all artists, what is to come. It's trying to say as much as it can before the lights go out. The gift that art gives humanity is a vision, a truthful vision of itself and its destiny. And also, it's like sunshine. It is really enhancing to existence. It is nourishing. And that's why the enemies of art and enemies of life hate it so much. I have to become someone else in order to walk onto the stage. Even doing a kind of interview like this, I have to invent a person to do it. You're not seeing me. You're seeing some new character that I've devised.